Hello, this is Craig from bitbox.co.uk. I am joined by Jeb.
Hello.
And I'm also joined by Wayne.
Hello.
So this is a little sort of a little discussion video on the campaign, the Tainting of Odessos. And before we go into all that, Jeb's just going to talk through sort of the epilogue and sort of how the last mission has affected the narrative. So I'll hand it straight over to Jeb.
Okay, as we have now hopefully all witnessed, things didn't go too well for the Chaos Forces, and no, indeed.
No.
Even with the aid of the Dark Skitarii at their side. And in fact, were pushed all the way back to their home of Hive Tertius. But not all was lost. The idea was they had a plan of evacuating the city and luring as much of the Imperial forces in and then detonating the Hive. Unfortunately, this didn't go too well. Shadow Captain Lanius of the Raven Guard did discover the plan and has indeed thwarted it. But the Hive still explodes, because unfortunately the damage to the generators is too great. And the Hive Tertius now on Odessos is completely erased. But unfortunately 90% of the Imperial forces escaped, so not quite to Chaos's emergency plan. But that's not the end of them. If we go back to Odessos and do further campaigns, which obviously we might be talking about in a minute, they are indeed now in the wastes with little war bands, but it kind of in ruins, so we'll see what happens there. So yeah, that was pretty much the campaign. The Hive exploded, and in its wake we now see a strange metallic artifact beneath the Hive itself. Clearly something lays awaiting.
But that's all we're going to say about that. So that's sort of like a little cliffhanger, and I'm sure, as Jeb say, there'll be further campaigns where we'll explore that in more detail. So, we'll go back to this campaign. Okay, so, this is the first ever sort of campaign we've done, and certainly the first over YouTube. So how do we find that? Jeb did a lot of the narrative. So, there's a lot of work there. So, sort of the idea came about, obviously you've probably all seen the mini wargaming campaigns, and then Wayne and Jeb came to me and said, well, why don't we do our own? And you don't really appreciate the work that goes in behind the scenes until you do one yourself, so
yep.
Sort of doff our caps to the mini wargaming team for all the ones they've done, certainly. And they do a lot more missions than we do. So, but we did 9, and I think our original plan was only about 6 or 7, but
Although at one stage I do believe it was like close to 15 or something.
Oh really?
So,
So we'll cut that down a little bit. I know there was a talk that it might only have been 7, but we got to 8. And 9 even, sorry. Can't even count. So yeah, there's all various sizes as well, which I quite enjoyed. It was nice doing different types of missions, and the kill team one was
I enjoyed the kill
quite
team
fun,
one.
Yeah.
It was nice and different.
Yeah. And it was nice and quick to do, and we managed to do 2.
Yeah,
film 2 that night, didn't we?
Yeah,
most of them have been filmed in the evenings as well, so they've been sort of quite some long evenings. The 5,000 point game was filmed over a couple of evenings because it was just so large.
Mm-hmm.
That was a good one to do. It's a good one to film and edit when you're doing just a recap one, so I can sort of see why a lot of people do that style, but I still prefer our regular style. So I've got a little list of things we're going to sort of talk about just in front of me. Well, first thing says, what have we learned from this campaign? Is there anything in particular you guys can think of off the top of your head?
Character names.
Yeah.
Some people.
Don't look on Wikipedia for fancy god names of fire.
Yeah, it took a lot of time to learn Kruzoltan's name. I mean, we were all forgetting that. We've probably edited out of videos, but just in the background you'll hear Jeb shouting Kruzoltan when Wayne's like, this guy, what's his name? So maybe a more memorable names for characters. I know the character death table thing, I'm not too happy with that. I think in future campaigns we'll literally just see if they die or not, and then just ignore sort of injuries, because we just forget they have them.
Yeah, well that was a nice way to at least test it.
We try and keep it as simple as possible, but we could even go simpler than that. I was thinking maybe someone, if they die like 3 times, like Zivik did all the time, then that could really affect their overall death quite easily. Yeah, and one thing to say about chaos characters, in future campaigns I'll probably have a bit more buffed up characters. Because the chaos characters you had just a basic sorcerer, a basic dark apostle, and then the chaos lord in Drachnos, who wasn't really too well. So compared to the Imperium characters, we had two chapter masters with Burn and Blade or Shield Tannel, and then one who's represented by Vulcan. So maybe we'll use some special character rules to represent some other more beefier characters, because the chaos characters just kept dying.
Yeah.
Unfortunately. It's tough for chaos. The Codex isn't the greatest in the world, but we had close games.
I thought there was not really any games I thought were a landslide, apart from maybe the Kill Team, but...
Yeah.
But that was a bit different because we had Chapter Master
in... Yeah, normally in a normal Kill Team you wouldn't have that guy, and you can see why after you play it, but, we can't just suddenly debuff a character vastly, so... And the whole idea was that he was just a big, buffed character and just...
We did try and balance the points, but... You can't really...
No, it's very hard. This game isn't balanced just regularly, so when you're trying to do a narrative behind it, well, it's very hard. But I think, overall, the missions did end up quite balanced.
Most of the games have been very bloody.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
Yeah, Chaos have done a lot of killing. I think if Chaos just had more long-range firepower, when I've been editing the videos, the shooting phases of Chaos have been so short compared to, the Imperium sides. That's sort of understandable when you're playing Guard, but... Yeah, in this edition, just shooting is just the key, and Chaos just falls short a little bit, unfortunately.
Yeah, it's normally there's one or two turns that just swung the game, I found, instead of just landsliding it across the entire game.
And both of your dices.
Oh, the dice, yes.
I'm getting rid of my dice.
Yeah, I'm also getting rid of my dice. I've been using the red and the green GW dice, but, I've never had much luck with GW dice, I have got some Chessex dice on the way as we speak, so in future videos you'll see some nice Bitsbox logo dice, which will be quite nice on the camera. So I'll be using them. Whether they'll roll any better, probably not, but they'll look a bit nice. And I know one thing I have learned from this campaign is not to use white pips on dice, because the lights, there's too much reflection coming off the light. So for now on, if it'll just be white dice with black pips for them, or...
And just did it for consistency.
That's why. I know someone commented saying you should throw your dice in the garbage, but you've kept them for consistency. They have done better than the green dice, that's for sure. Jesus. We're going to go through each mission individually, and there's a couple where my dice have just been awful. Mm. And the one we just filmed had a couple of quite outstanding moments. For the dice, if you're watching this, you may have already watched that video, so you'll know what we're talking about. So yeah, It seems so long ago from the first mission now, because we must have started a good 2 or 3 months ago.
Because
we already played about 3 missions before these started going up on YouTube. And we were sort of doing them once a week or once every 2 weeks, so we were sort of quite far ahead of ourselves. So it seems so long ago for them. But before we go on the missions, there's another sort of thing I want to notice, what we liked and disliked. So we'll just... Liked is quite easy, because I think most of it has been just really enjoyable.
Yeah, and it's nice to get regular games in.
I've only played one other game apart from this campaign in about the last two months, and that was the one against Alex, which was on the channel, which I got absolutely slaughtered in. So, yeah, I've won 2 out of my last 10 games, so hooray for Chaos. But I was happy with the ones we did win, and we'll go through them, as I said, in detail. So, yeah, I definitely liked Chaos winning a couple, and I disliked them losing the others, so simple as that, I think.
I think it's nice that we kept consistent, although we have painted models and stuff. Might be a bit plain every now and then, Skitarii and stuff like that. Because Skitarii released in the beginning of the campaign.
That's something we should talk about as well as releases, because while this campaign's been going on, for Skitarii and Cult Mechanic has been released, so have Corn Demonkin, and also Space Marines. The new Space Marine Codex was released sort of during this campaign towards the end. We'd still use the old Codex just for consistency.
Yeah, because it was only one game. There was no point really.
Hasn't made a big difference at all. So, but yeah, for me that was only the second game I used Corn Demonkin. I would have had another game, I think with Alex as well, quite early on, campaign. So, which I think I lost as well. So, so I'm into about 11. So, yeah, that was only my second game with Corn Demonkin. And for you, that might be your first
one. That was my first one, yeah. And we'd literally. It was only, 2 weeks since it came out?
Yeah.
We just rushed as many models painted as we could just to get it in there.
Yeah, that's another good thing about this campaign is it's got us to paint models.
Yes.
Yeah, I've painted more in the last 2 months and the lead up to it than I have ever. I mean, I've got four painted armies now where I never had a full painted army before.
So that's good, yeah. I've painted up a few bits of Chaos. Obviously, all three Chaos characters were made just for this campaign. I never had them before. There was also a Mauler Fiend. I don't know if he's about anywhere. Yeah, this guy.
Somewhere. Oh, mm.
This little Mauler Fiend here I made for this campaign. I think Blight Drone. He was made as well, even though I already had him, so he was painted up.
Actually got to use your Chaos Knight.
Yes, I got to use the Chaos Knight.
That was nice, actually, using the Knights Codex as well.
Yeah, that's another codex which also came out as well, yeah, so that's five, so... Yeah, another codex, what came out was the Knights, and we used them. And of course I got to use my newly painted Knights as well.
Mm.
Or you got to use them, I should say. I got to be killed by them.
Yeah, so they did do that well as well.
Yeah, they're very good. And of course, for me, it was the first time using Skitarii as well, and this last mission which we've just played, first time using full Skitarii and just don't know anything. Like normally I'm using Chaos or something like that, I just know most of the stats and stuff by heart, you just don't think about it, but when it's a new army, just looking up stuff all the time. I mean, that was a quick game, but we could have played even quicker if we sort of...
Yeah, I mean, for a 1,000 points it still took us 2.5 hours or so.
Yeah.
It does take a lot longer when you're having to stop and record
when
it all the time.
When you're filming, I mean...
Yeah.
You don't realise it does add a good couple of hours onto a game.
Yeah. And our first game, and we'll talk about it in a minute, took about 6 hours or something.
Yeah.
It was just
that was draining.
And,
that was.
And that's another thing we've learned, is how long it takes, because we just didn't expect it to be that much. I mean, I've filmed battle reports before, but normally, I don't know, there's been less narrative and sort of...
That was just quick infantry heavy.
And that was infantry heavy, yeah, so... Yeah, that's been... That was quite an experience. My legs were just aching by the end of that one. Just standing up for a while. I'm glad we're sitting down there. That's the first time we've managed to sit down this whole campaign, I think.
Yeah.
So. Okay, so, yeah, we'll go through each mission, just sort of what we liked about it and stuff like that, just very quickly. So, first one was Delectable Delegates, and that's the one where we had the governor and a big line of Deathcore Krieg. That's certainly what I liked, was just seeing all them Krieg models, and I know
had a lot of moments.
Yes, it was nice to actually use my Krieg. I've been trying to collect them for ages, but I never get to play them.
Yeah.
It's been really good fun.
A lot of people have said, well, when are we going to see the Krieg again? Because we just didn't have them for a little while in the middle. And we're certainly going to have more Krieg games. So just maybe some standalone ones, or even more with the Krieg. Because they're certainly popular.
I need to get a bit more for them,
I think. They are beautiful models. That's a really nice army you've got there with them. I didn't realise how much you had as well.
Yeah.
Especially when, I think it was at Mission 8, I think, when we played the big 5,000 point, you had a lot of Krieg.
Yeah. I had, I think, all but 7 of my Krieg models in that game. But
that was a lot.
Yeah. That was a good mission, actually. I enjoyed that one.
Well, I'm just going back to another what we've learned. Now, I've learned that you actually need a lot of models when you're doing a campaign just to repair
it
up. There's a lot of units I had to use more than once, like my Corn Berserkers.
Yeah. My Space Marine Force, I've only really got one or two lists for, and that's the problem there. Because I build them to play the occasional game with when I do need to explain.
Variation.
So, certainly need a lot more models, really, but I think we sort of did well with what we had.
Yeah, I think so.
Up a lot. So, Delectable Delegates, that didn't go too great for Chaos. I had a lot of Colossus and Zombies, so just a lot of weak stuff just getting shot to pieces by Guardsmen. But the whole idea was it's like a hive city that's been corrupted, so it's a lot of sort of citizens and that who have all just turned to Chaos, and a lot of dead and stuff like that. So,
yeah.
And of course, Zilic. Yeah.
It was still fairly close, I thought, in the end.
That was very close, yeah.
Just got a bit unlucky with trying to kill them chimeras.
Yeah. I mean, I had the obliterators in there as well, didn't they?
Yeah.
Trying to think back to it now.
Oh, spawns.
And spawn, yes, yeah, you love chaos spawn.
Bane! Every time they kill everything I've got.
Yeah, they did quite well in a few missions. Towards the end they were sort of first people being killed off shockingly, but yeah, noble spawn. I always run my noble spawn, I love my noble spawn.
I quite liked having the mutal if I thought in that as well.
Yeah, that's true, yeah.
Mix it up with something different just for the narrative, I thought. Getting that mission.
Yeah, I completely forgot about that. It's just like you're just using Tyranid rules.
He didn't really do anything like that.
No, he popped up and surrounded and
died. Yeah, he used Tyranid rules, so.
I think in the future, perhaps we should do more like that, like have a random.
Yeah, I'd quite like that.
Stuff.
Yeah, definitely. Especially, it sort of works well with chaos. Yeah. You can sort of do that stuff and get away with it.
And in the narrative campaigns, it works a lot better. It gives you a bit more flexibility.
Yeah, that's another thing with narrative campaigns, you can sort of bend the rules quite a bit. And sort of
definitely the Force organisation.
Oh, I don't think I went bound.
We haven't really played our victims a lot. There's only been a couple of missions where there's been sort of regular type objectives. Some missionaries even forgot to mention them. That's one thing I can really focus on. Sometimes we'll just jump straight into a mission because you know, excited to get it started and stuff like that, and just sort of forget what we're even playing for. But you know, as the mission goes on, you sort of see what we're playing for anyway. Like, and we'll go on to Clash of Alignment, because that did use objectives. I had one either side, if I remember.
Yes, that was the Emperor's Will, I believe.
Yeah,
that was a good one.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of the times we're just sort of just taking regular missions and using them, or just doing something simple, so. But yeah, that was a good one, and we got to see the Emerald Aces in that one. My custom Space Marine chapter. And who were led by Chapter Master Killmister, who's just beefed up.
He is awesome.
Yeah, he's done very well.
And the dreaded Deredio was
in there. Yes, that's the one.
We did get the Skyfire thing slightly wrong, but I still think that thing would have just slaughtered anyway.
It was so good, isn't it? Yeah, very good. Fordwell do come up with some really nice stuff, and he's certainly one of them. I think he's just behind us here.
He is. But star of that match.
He was the star of the match. I love the model as well.
And yeah, it's a lovely
very ad mech. Mech warrior even. But
yeah, I did try and fit him in a couple of the other games, but just couldn't find the points.
Yeah, you didn't need points. Yeah, like Grand Centurions as well. Brutal end. I think in Crash of the Line, they did lose a couple, or one, or
they lost one early on, and you did Overwatch with them, which was wrong.
Yes,
but
that's true.
I've
done that in games, so just remember that. But yeah, I'm quite happy with my Emerald Aces. Got a nice colour scheme going. I'm certainly going to add more of those in New Space Marine Codex. So maybe we'll see more of them in the future, or just in regular battle reports, I'm sure you'll see them. So yeah, and that was mainly just against sort of Nurgle forces again, wasn't it? And that was Mulgun Glutwort.
Yes, who perils himself to death.
Yes. Yeah, my poor hapless chaos heroes just die a lot. Although he did sort of redeem himself later on in the campaign, as we'll talk about, because he's a bit more survivable then. But yes, he periled himself and just stuck on warp. So Outpost 212 was the next one, and that was the first time we'd ever used the Table War Snow style battle map. And that sort of looked alright on camera. It does throw the white balance a bit, but that wasn't as bad as I thought it would be. Sort of the camera's not too bad when it comes to sort of the auto balance, so. But yeah, it's nice to use this sort of snowy terrain, and that's the first time we used Khorne Demonkin and Skatari, and we sort of learned a lot about them two armies here.
Yes.
I really took advantage of the blood type thing. I had lots of small squads with champions, so blood type points were just flowing, and that just turned the game into the Khorne Demonkin's favour. So, first win for Chaos, which was nice. So, and of course that, which I think was good because it sort of lent us having Skatari for the rest of the mission, has sort of opened up sort of a couple of the missions, like the final one we probably wouldn't have had without Skatari. So,
changed the narrative in a
way. Yes. Yeah, we did try and keep the narrative open, so it wasn't just like, here's the destination that we've got, and we're just going to go down this one path. It was like every battle changed the course of it.
Yeah, and the next battle, the Rift, was certainly quite a big one in
very
terms of that.
One.
That was
yes.
a very important one. And had Chaos won it, it could have been a very different campaign.
Yes, that was the turning point, I think. Really.
Yeah, it was really where the deciding factor of how aggressive then the Imperial forces could
yeah.
be, which turns out they're very aggressive.
Yeah. Yeah, so again, that was another one with Paul and Zilek, I think, in the Rift, just trying to...
Yes, yes, with the Bloodthirster.
Yep, that's right, with the Bloodthirster as well.
Couldn't kill Stangard.
No, that's right, some more great dice rolls on my part. So yeah, even with Khorne Demonkin using Blood Dive Points and demons coming out of a rift and the Sultan, which is a rule we added in,
yes.
even that didn't make it, you know, well enough for Chaos to win, so it wasn't really overpowered as much as we thought it could have been. So it's still another well-balanced mission, but at the end of the day, they just got overwhelmed by the Space Marines, so...
That was quite close, though.
Yeah, it was quite close. Yeah, but then they all have been fairly close, so... So that was good, but yeah, could have been a completely different narrative had Chaos won that. And you probably notice there's no more demons, really, apart from just the Bloodthirster now, and then after that, once the Warbrift was closed, that was it. So then we went on to the Hunt. So the next two missions, that was when we didn't have Jab with us then, so... if there was extra mistakes in that one, or in them two, then...
Yes, I'm normally lurking in the background.
Yes. Yeah, it's always nice to have a third person who sort of notices it. Or even better when there's like 1,000 watching, yeah. They certainly notice their mistakes then. So yeah, the Hunt, there's a little kill team mission. We weren't using the GW ones. We were using, was it Heralds of
Ruin? Yes, Heralds of Ruin.
I actually quite like them. You even get little army lists and stuff like that. So you can use single models, which I think is what a kill team should be. It shouldn't be... a few, like one or two small squads, it should just be individuals working.
Yeah, and unless you buy like squads of cultists and stuff like that as well, and Terminators.
You can actually get Terminators in there as well. I know someone mentioned about not being able to have 2+8, so you actually can in the Herald of Rule. Yeah. You still can't have Terminators.
If you enjoy small skirmish games, it's definitely a must.
Yeah.
It's really big down our local store, that's for sure.
It's quite an interesting rule set. Do you think it's got a lot of potential, especially tying in with narrative games?
Yeah, there's
well.
Different ones of like Death Watch and Harlequins and
Gene
Steel Cult, yeah.
So yeah, maybe we'll do some of them.
I would like to.
As standalone missions as well, just for the channel. Because they're very quick, you can just do an hour or two, which is really nice. So yeah, the Hunt, and that was when Paul Siddick met his maker, so that was him gone. I think he's always just going to be the first one to go.
Yeah, I'm watching Lane just slaughter his way through that.
Oh yeah, he just went through half the army. And then some Chaos Cultists took a wound off him and shoot him, which is quite funny.
Which is amusing.
Yeah.
But, yeah, it's four, so...
Yeah.
Never going to finish him off. And then the Dead Stall served. So that's when the Creed came back.
Yeah, that didn't go quite so well.
No surprise... No surprise that that's had quite a few views, because the Krieg have been very popular. And yeah, and Chaos won that one as well, and that was probably the most one-sided one, at least in
Chaos.
Yeah,
I mean, that was only like 3 turns, wasn't it?
Yeah.
We filmed that faster than the kill team.
I mean, the video is actually shorter, so I'll say more about that. But yeah, that was quite surprising. I thought that'd be a bit closer, but Chaos actually did alright in that one. Narrative-wise, it didn't really have much effect, but...
Yeah, it got Mulgrim back and
So that was nice.
It was more just so you could get a picture of what happened at the outpost rather than actually trying to story really, wouldn't it?
And explain that there is other operations going on.
Yeah.
What I liked about it the most is that the Nurgle army you saw was literally meant to be the Khorne army from Mission 3, just sort of all their dead sort of risen again. So like the Plague Marines are meant to be the dead. And berserkers and the zombies are meant to be the dead cultists, and then that glorious rhino.
Oh, yes.
He came back.
The rhino of doom.
And did some more. So, yeah, that was quite cool. If I'd had more models and we were playing bigger points, I'd probably had some points cards and stuff in there. But I think that was only 750 points, wasn't it? So.
Yeah, I think so. Or maybe 1,000, I can't remember.
It wasn't that small.
It's been nice to mix it up. Like, our average has been 2,000, odd, hasn't it?
Yeah, a lot more. Sort of 1,500, 2,000. So then it's the Breach, and that's the one with the Imperial Knights, and That, yeah, that's probably more enjoyable for you than it was for me.
That formation proved a lot nastier than I thought. I read it, and I thought, okay, free up invite on the front, not bad. We have to stay within six of each other, so that could be hard to do on, you know, quite a city board. But, yeah, they just would not die.
No, I only managed to kill one.
Crazy good,
either.
Yeah.
There was a few moments I thought you could have potentially killed in that one, but your dice are bad.
Oh, yeah, the dice in that one.
Like, the obliterates came down and whiffed there to all the rolls.
That was the game where I rolled snake eyes about seven times. It was just... My
amazing.
God, I've never. I mean, I've rolled bad, but I've never rolled like that.
We did discuss having knights. It wasn't like I turned up and went, "Here you go, Craig. Here's three knights.
Yeah,
deal
with
that."
Yeah, there's none of that.
We share the army list quite often. And,
And
try and make a quick balance of fun.
You know, I did put a lot of melters and obliterates on that list as well. But just the dice. I'd probably counts would have probably still lost if the dice were a bit better, but it probably would have been so overwhelming. That was just. That was a shame, really. I'm glad I did take one night out, but I think if the dice were a bit better, I could have probably took two.
Yeah.
And then Dragnos got all brave and decided to charge one, and Mulgrin was in combat with one and survived somehow.
Which
and
is
even,
impressive.
And even when Kilmister came in at the end to just fight, finish him off, he still survived, so proper Nurgle resilience there, so a little bit of
that,
glory.
I think that was like the only time a Chaos character survived as well.
Quite possibly, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is... Quite something in this campaign. So yeah, and then mission 8, so last sacrifice, and that was a big one with the palace.
That, yeah. Yes. That was quite fun actually, I did enjoy filming that one.
That was good because it gave us an opportunity to use so many different models we don't normally use. Like, first time in this edition I've used a Brass Scorpion.
Yeah.
First time I've used a Chaos Knight, as you mentioned earlier.
Got Chastigator in.
Yeah.
I got to use my Stormlord.
Yeah,
lots of tanks.
Yeah.
If I'd have just killed that Stormlord, I got it down to a single hull point.
That was the turn.
Yeah, the Demon Prince couldn't take that last hull point off it, so that was a shame. If we'd have just killed that. I mean, the Crash Centurions would have mopped up a few seconds.
That was quite a dirty tactic, I thought, but then inside the Stormlord.
Yes. Crash Centurions and the Stormlord was brutal. Hey, for anyone watching, if they want to try that, then. They'll have no friends, but you'll do well. You'll do well.
Yeah, I am normally that guy.
It was a good episode, though, for a lot of camera moments and...
Yeah, there was a lot of picturesque moments.
If you've watched it and you're a fan of, like, the little bits in between, like, the little panoramic shots going around the board, you can thank Jab for that. That's all his work. I really like that as well. So in future missions, I think we'll probably add some stuff like that.
Yeah, we do try and remember, but...
Yeah,
sometimes we get a bit...
Yeah, we're normally quite involved in the game, so we just forget everything else.
But on a big one like that, it was quite good. We reached a full 8x4 as well.
Mm.
So yeah, another thing I should mention, sort of terrain-wise, I certainly need a lot more as well. Using the same cities over again is a bit... Yeah, it gets a bit sort of dull in the end. When you're trying to represent different parts of a city, or even different hive cities, and... all together trying to use them. I mean, I used a different table war map for like one of the hive cities and then just a regular grey board I've got for the other one. So in the last few missions you just see a lot of sort of grey board and the same sort of buildings. But yeah, so in future ones I'll probably get some more buildings in, some more different types of terrain. I certainly need to do that.
Yeah, I want to get like some trench works to count as Wall of Martyrs and stuff like that.
Yeah, that would be brilliant. So yeah, so... Definitely something for future. I mean, that's just generically as well. Like, when you start filming them, you sort of just realise how much...
As we started getting in, like, three or four missions in, we did start to realise, we should have had a bit more.
It was quite an urban campaign anyway, taking place in three hive seas.
I think the outpost missions were quite nice just to sort of break that up a bit.
Yeah, definitely.
So, yeah, and then the final mission, which we've literally... We're filming this straight after we've played it.
Mm.
Was Let the Galaxy Burn, and first time I've ever used like full Skitarii army. I expect them to do a little bit better, but sort of towards the end they sort of redeem themselves a bit, but they are just they're a bit of a glass cannon. They just
First turn from during your first turn is really good for me, you know, ruins four up. Then we had Knight Fighting on, so that's a plus one, and then Raven Guard getting an extra plus one from the old codex. That was just two up cover saves.
Yeah.
Saved me.
Yeah, you used cover quite well. So Scutaria may not have a great deal of cover in the deployment zone.
We did try and put it.
But they had enough, but you know, I had to sort of get over an offensive because all the Raven Guard was sort of hiding as well, so I sort of had to get in positions where I could shoot them, but that just left me vulnerable.
Yeah.
So in hindsight, you know, maybe I could, I don't know, maybe make you come to me, but
it was
that
a
was
lot
probably less interesting than me.
Yeah,
there's
a lot of these Assault Marines killing stuff
and
rather than
means,
the shooting for me. My Tactical Marines apparently sucked.
Yeah.
And just could not kill anything. No. Not all game.
But of course, yeah, everyone says like Assault Marines are a bit rubbish, but for Raven Guard, I mean, you know, they are fair.
Yeah, the ability to jump out twice and reroll the Hammer of Wrath really came to play.
I mean, look how many died from Hammer of Wrath.
Well, yeah, the first assault, I annihilated that squad just from Hammer of Wrath.
Yeah. So that was quite brutal. And just the number of attacks they give, they don't get on with the Hammer of Wrath, and squads of 10, I know it's probably a fair amount of points, but...
Yeah, I mean, that was most of my points sunk into them two squads, and...
But for a mission like that,
the
it
Chapter Master, so... And again, he did fantastic.
Yeah, he could take on squads of Scutari, no problem.
I don't normally take pimped up Uber Lords, but apparently they work for me, so...
if you can give them a really strong... Like, it's not like Burn and Blade, or just like an initiative with a Storm Shield, it's like, just brutal, isn't it? And a big squad to just soak up wounds for him, or he can soak up stuff with his 2+, which is, he did quite a lot as well.
Yes. Yeah, he did really well, I thought.
Works very well. So yeah, cool. I'm a HQ on the other side, on the other hand. One of my favourite models of recent releases, the Tech Priest.
Tech Priest Dominus.
Yeah, it's such a beautiful model. I got one myself, which I want to paint up. But yeah, he doesn't seem very brave. He just ran away.
Your morale checks.
I wouldn't have run away from Lanius, to be fair.
True. But morale checks for Scutari, like in Last Sacrifice, I rolled down 6 twice for morale checks. And in this one, I think I failed all of them. In the assault phase, at least.
Yeah.
Alright, they were heavily modified, but yeah, they weren't not the bravest of them. Models.
Beginning to realise they were working for the bad guys.
Yeah, I think so. So that's all the missions, I think. You know, it was a good campaign, I think a successful from our point of view. We've had quite a few views, and as we film this, there's been over 1,000 in the first one, and you know, a few hundred in each of the other ones. Hopefully there'll be more. There certainly won't be less, so I don't know the way YouTube works, so that's certainly good, but I'm sort of happy with the numbers we've got from, like, you know, we're even filming.
And the comments have been pretty nice as well. I mean, there's been a few, like, saying about rule mistakes, but everyone just says, you know...
Yeah, we do get
that. Everyone makes mistakes.
Yeah, you can't... Another thing about filming battle reports is you cannot film one without any mistakes, it's just impossible.
We do try,
how long you've been playing the game for, how well you know the rules, there's always something. And... Well, I quite like that, because it's a good way of learning if you got all these people watching it and they can point out your mistakes. We then learn, because we don't tend to make the mistakes continuously if we've been told about them. We sort of remember. Like, I'm sure someone commented saying, like, I don't want to be that guy, but you did this wrong. I'm like, please be that guy. Because if you tell us what we've done wrong, you know, that'll just make us get it right. So, if you do see any rules wrong, please don't hesitate to ask, because we don't take offence or anything, you know.
Sometimes we know it's afterwards, of course. But,
there's been a few times, like, after the game, or a couple of times down the line, we forgot stuff.
Yeah. I mean, what was it, in Outpost 212, I forgot that I gave everything Feel No Pain, and then I'd go back and roll all these Feel No Pain rules, and all of a sudden, Corbazones were popping back up from the dead. It's like, idiot, but... You know, when you...
That happens, though. Yeah. We were getting quite into that game, to be fair.
Yeah, especially with newer codexes as well. You know, using them, it's never going to be implanted in your brain, but... I think overall, you know, we need to be known the basics.
Yeah.
We've got a lot more right than we've got wrong, at least, so that's...
Yeah, I don't think we did too much wrong, to be fair.
No, but then, as I say, other people will notice when we don't, but... Yeah, hopefully, fingers crossed, we've done alright. But yeah, it's been really enjoyable. I keep looking over there because we've still got a train set up from the last game. That poor host city, which is no more.
Yeah.
So yeah, so all that's left really, you ought to ask something about the Death Call, I believe.
Yes, we've got obviously a couple of ideas for further campaigns. even some ideas, perhaps a Horus Heresy campaign sometime, as we all slowly grow our collection. But the Krieg obviously have been asked for quite heavily, which is a good thing, you know, a lovely army. And so perhaps maybe if people want, you can like comment below, obviously, or whatever. And we're thinking a campaign orientated around the Krieg, like following this company's travels in some kind of war zone, essentially, where so the Krieg are the main character following their trials.
Yeah.
And so.
Yeah, so it would be more Krieg. I mean, it could just be a mini campaign, but just following them. And as Jab mentioned, there could be a Horus Heresy one coming up. Mm. And I've had quite a good idea for Heresy, where you're like following.
Yeah, similar thing, sort of thing, like trials of the 10th Legion or whatever, following them through a war zone. Perhaps even their own experiencing the heresy as such.
Yeah, I quite like that idea. So heresy going on, sort of like midway through this campaign, it sort of starts, and then we see sort of how that affects.
Start with them like pacifying some local forces or whatever.
Yeah.
And then having allies turning on them.
Because we've all got
escaping.
Horus Heresy armies. Is that correct?
Yes.
So yeah.
I've got my ad mech.
Death Guard.
Yeah, I've got Imperial Fists. So.
And we're all trying to increase our collections, that's for sure.
Yeah, so definitely more Horus Heresy battle reports as well, because I think the one what me and you did was...
Yeah, I definitely want to get one of my...
So, yeah, there'll be more of them as well. So, yeah, so all that's left really is just to see what you guys think, really, just if there's anything you like, disliked about the campaign, anything you think we should have done better, or anything that you really, really, really enjoyed. Anything really, just comments, suggestions, please leave them below. Also like the video, subscribe to the channel if you've not already done so, we'd really appreciate that. We've only been filming now for about 8 months, I think it is, Battle Reports. But quality I hope is improving as we go, we're certainly learning stuff. But I'm really enjoying it, it's literally just something we do in our spare time. You know, there's no financial gain or anything like that, it's just, we enjoy doing it, I certainly enjoy filming it,
it's nice motivation as well.
Yeah. Yeah, because I have one rule, and that is that your army must be painted, so that's good motivation for being painted, because no one wants to see a load of greenery. But that's about it. So, a big thanks to Wayne and Jab for doing the campaign. Especially Jab for the narrative, that's been very, very good, and thanks to Wayne for playing the games. I'm sure in the next campaign we'll get Jab to play a few games as well, or maybe even most of them, so that'd be very cool. So, all that's left to say is I'll see you in the next video.